Okay, this is important. One of the defining movies of my childhood, Beetlejuice. Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice. This movie. I love this movie. It starts out with the lovely married couple. They're taking a vacation at home. It's Gina Davis and Alec Baldwin. They're so nice and everything's all picturesque, and little do they know, they're in a Tim Burton movie. And little did audiences know at the time. Before Beetlejuice, there was what? Pee-wee's Big Adventure, and I like that movie, I do. But it's like it's this was Beetlejuice. It was kind of like the first movie to stand out as a uniquely Tim Burton movie, and kind of announce his voice and his inspired erratic genius to the world. And I can't imagine how exciting this movie must have been to see at the time, and how different it really was. And kind of really right from the beginning, it plays against certain like expectations, perceptions you have, because like the movie opens with the trademark Danny Elfman score that you'll see in plenty of other Tim Burton movies after that. It's going over like the landscape, and you see the city and the houses, cars, everything like that. But then you see a giant spider, and it's like, oh, okay, so this is just a model. And so I think that kind of sets up everything you need to know about the movie, and about Tim Burton in kind of a way too. And the movie itself, I mean, it's so hard to really kind of describe or categorize, because it is so different. I mean, the movie, like I saw it when I was a kid, you can categorize it as a kid's movie. They, made like the TV show, Beetlejuice, which I watched all the time too, but that's another story. And they made toys. I had the toys too. So yeah, I mean, definitely part of it at least was a kid's movie, but there's some pretty dark stuff here. I mean, you don't see too many kids' movies quite like this. But I don't know, is it like a comedy? Is it a horror? Pretty much this movie, it just stands in a league of its own, completely, entirely, really. And I think it is kind of okay to categorize it as maybe like a sort of family-friendly movie, though you won't see too many that drop the F-bomb. They do it once in this movie. Nice fucking model is what Beetlejuice says. I can see why. Because it does have comedic elements to it. And the thing about this movie, and what makes it so different, is that in a way it does kind of demystify the whole haunted house concept, when you think about it. Like, okay, ghosts are scary, but what this does, I mean, like you see the couple at the beginning of the movie, and you think, okay, maybe something's gonna happen here, they're gonna encounter ghosts or anything. But then before the first 10 minutes of the movie are over, they're dead, they're ghosts. So by empathizing with the ghosts, making them the main characters, and making the family that they haunt the antagonists of the movie, really, I mean, it flips it over in a really, really crazy kind of way, which just, I don't know, it just works so well. And kind of the thing about this movie is that I do know, like I've read that apparently in earlier drafts of the screenplay, it was meant to be more of a darker movie, more of a horror-centered movie. And I don't know, I guess kind of whatever they saw in that, they said, wait a minute, we can make this a little bit more amusing. And I'm so glad they did that, because it is such a funny movie. What they do really well is they create this whole kind of other universe of the afterlife, where it's like going to the DMV. There's like just the litigiousness, if that's a word, or litigiosity or whatever, of death, of the afterlife, having to read the manual, the handbook for the recently deceased, and all the weird, crazy rules and procedures and things like that, and the very funny waiting room scenes, which apparently were supposed to be really tragic and scary or whatever. But oh my God, that scene with the caseworker and the football team, and they don't realize that they're dead. Ugh, that's just so funny. Like, I don't think something like that would work. If they approached it more seriously, I think it would be just too much, you know what I mean? So being a comedy and being this kind of unique Tim Burton, larger than life, full of colors and gothic imagery and very, very innovative special effects. Like, even watching it today, you kind of appreciate it more because of the harder work that had to go into the effects. Like, I mention this every single video about 80s movies, but it's like, boom, today, do it with CGI, no problem. But here it's like, wow, how'd they do that? And it's really cool kind of stuff. From the afterworld perspective, it's really interesting. And the human world is interesting too. I mean, you got the mother and father character, and Lydia, played by Winona Ryder. Oh, when I was a kid, I had such a crush on her. She grew older as I grew older. The crush continues. I love Winona Ryder so much. But and this is one of her best roles, I think. Like, she's really, really good at playing that kind of just somber, gothic kid, I guess. But she's really, really good in the movie. And I think kind of the weird thing that stems from the movie and her real parents and how the Geena Davis and the Alec Baldwin characters, they do become kind of surrogate parents to her. Because I guess because she's such a little oddball, and only the real people who can really understand her are dead people, I guess. So I guess there's that. But at the heart of it all is the title character, the man of the hour, Beetlejuice, played by Michael Keaton, who is fucking brilliant in this movie. Oh my god! Like he's in the movie, a small fraction of the movie, in like 90-minute movie. Less than 20 minutes, he's in it, but every scene he's in is just totally dominated by Keaton and his performance, which every second he's on screen, I am desperately trying to not bust out laughing, failing miserably. He's just so good. He is, I don't know what possessed him in this movie, but it's just manic genius, this performance. He is like a living cartoon character, just come to life with this manic energy that's just almost overwhelming at how good he plays it and how funny he is and how absurd it is. But, oh man, he's so good. And, like, oh, I honestly think, I know, like, the Academy doesn't really, like, pay too much respect to comedies. I think maybe in later years they're kind of opening up to it. But I think a performance like this, it should have gotten him like an Oscar nomination or something. One of Michael Keaton's best performances, if not his best. Because definitely when you look at the movies he does, they're so varied and different. Like he's always been one of my favorite actors. Like, when I was a kid, there was movies like this and like Batman. And to a lesser extent, Jack Frost, but let's not talk about that. But then maybe as you grow older or, look to see his different roles. Like, he can do pretty much anything. Like Clean and Sober, what he did there in a really, really dramatic role. And something also funny, like Night Shift, that movie with Henry Winkler where the morticians set up a prostitution ring. Great movie, by the way. You guys see that if you haven't seen it. And yeah, even like Jackie Brown, something like that. But he's always so great, such great energy. One of my favorites. And this Beetlejuice, it has to be, the jewel on his crown. This is just the character is his. Nobody else can top what he's done in this character if they ever decide to make a sequel. Which you always hear rumors about a sequel, but I don't know. If it's not Keaton, I wouldn't be interested. But I love the movie, and it is probably my favorite Tim Burton movie. He's like I've talked about his other movies too in some detail, but I think this kind of encapsulates all that he's capable of, and the really great imagination that he has as a filmmaker, and the attention to detail that he has in so many things. Like, this is just such a great movie. It really is. And so funny and so morbid, really just right up my alley. So, I don't know. Every time I watch it, I get something different. Like, when I saw this as a kid and watched the cartoon, it's like pretty different stuff there, but always something that you can gain from watching this movie. And every performance I thought was great. Catherine O'Hara, Jeffrey Jones, Alec Baldwin, Geena Davis, Winona Ryder, even guest appearances by Dick Cavett, Robert Goulet. Oh, and that one other guy. What is his name? I don't know, but he's so good in it. The interior decorator. I forget his name. I know he's a notable character actor, but he's so good and so funny in the movie. Just a movie that I think everything in it comes together very perfectly in that offbeat kind of way. Like it has a very, very happy ending, all things considered, considering the happy couple dies before the first 10 minutes of the movie are over, and that's an evil fucking demon is trying to kill a family and try and marry off the daughter and Lord knows do what with her. But everything works out nice, and you still like the Beetlejuice character, and he gets his comeuppance at the end, and it's very funny. And you know, the family is together at the end, floating and dancing to while the ghost football players are in the background on the staircase. It's a great movie. Yeah, but something you gotta watch every Halloween time, or every October, or every Christmas. Any old time is good for Beetlejuice. It's one of the greats, one of the best Tim Burton movies, if not his best, my personal favorite of his, and you can't top Michael Keaton as Beetlejuice. And yeah, that's pretty much my review. So, thanks again for watching.